Editing pitches in Ableton is really simple. If you just need to clean up a few notes here and there, they need a little extra attention and love. It's really quick and simple to get those adjusted. So I have a line here where this last note, I'm considerably pitchy. So let's take a quick listen to it. All right, so this definitely needs some sort of a lift underneath it in order to make it fit in with the key. So I'm going to zoom in here, and what I like to do is to just isolate the syllable or part of the region that I want to adjust and separate it from the rest of the file. So I've got this highlighted, and I'm going to use the key command, Command E or Control E on a PC in order to split this region. Then I'm going to double click. And you can see here it is. So over here in the sample properties, I have a transpose knob where I can notch this up considerably. Here's 5 steps. Here's -8. So it's pretty cool. It's not gonna adjust the timing, it's just gonna adjust the pitch, which is the essence of warping in Ableton. So I'm not a half step flat, I'm just kind of flat. So this detune parameter, you can see it's measured in cents, which is a much more granular sort of in-between pitch measurement, whereas this transpose knob is going to adjust things in semitones, which is equivalent to a half step. So I feel like maybe I just need to bump this up a certain amount. So let's try 37 cents and see what happens here. Maybe a little too much. Pull back just slightly. And you can hear this like digitized thing that's happening to the file when I pitch it. So that's why when you're comping and editing, the choices you make about pitch and timing really do matter, because the more you have to make these adjustments in post, the more digitized or obvious those edits are going to become. This is a lot better than it was, and especially once I EQ, compress this, put some reverb on it, it probably will be unnoticeable to everybody else that listens to it, besides you and me now.